And we're now joined by DFA Migrant Workers Affairs Undersecretary, or rather, let me correct that, we are now joined by DFA Undersecretary Eduardo De Vega. Good morning, Undersecretary. Thank you for making time for ANC.
Good morning.
Okay, sir, first, we mentioned in previous reports mentioned that 40 Filipinos left Gaza earlier this week, but we have to clarify that only 35 Filipinos are actually expected to return to Manila. Kindly explain to our viewers what happened to the other five Filipinos and why aren't they coming back to Manila anytime soon?
34 now.
34.
Not just 35. Nabawasan pa ng isa, 34. Although there will be 35 coming because one is the Palestinian wife.
All right. Go ahead, sir. Explain what happened. Why were some Filipinos who were able to leave Gaza opted not to come back to the Philippines?
Yes. Three have opted not to come back to the Philippines because they are getting their Egyptian residency papers. Because the husband is Egyptian, was already in Egypt, and is working for the mother and two children to get a permanent residence in Egypt. So that's a decision they made. So, but they are safe. There are three others who will eventually go home. But right now, one is a lady who is about to give birth. She's about 38 weeks pregnant. So she has to stay in Cairo. She's not allowed to fly, and her Filipino mother and a two-year-old kid are staying with her. So that makes six. So that's 34 of the 40 Filipinos right now as we speak on board a flight back to the Philippines.
All right. Glad to hear that, Undersecretary. We know that the government will be providing several aid packages for them once they come home, once they arrive in Manila. But let's talk about the 16 Palestinian spouses who were allowed to return to the Philippines. How difficult was it actually for the DFA to negotiate their return to the Philippines, considering that Israel initially did not allow Palestinian nationals to leave Gaza?
Like in all diplomatic, all diplomatic representations, it's difficult. But one thing which assisted us, which helped us, was the fact that some other nationalities had Palestinian spouses join their spouses. So that helped a bit. The only thing is, the Israelis made it clear that they have to pass security clearance, and unfortunately some did not.